So until the teachers join, let's go over what issues you have, so that I can probably solve whatever issues you have so far. So mostly I hear from students is, or I just went through the chats of all the groups. So like they're saying not able to see a subject to join the meeting. Unable to hear is one big complaint, and not able to see the screen, it's too small, is another one, and a lot of background noise. Is there anything else that you want to add? Is there anything else?
Hey, first period completed, sir. When I started second period for 4th D, I thought a few pictures for them to show and to explain, but all these pop-ups, all these like end meeting, the remaining share options, all those were not visible, sir.
Visible to you?
Is that your meeting also?
Is that your meeting or did you join as an attendee?
My meeting only, sir. I started second period. In first period, I recorded the meeting. That period I completed. Then I started second period. Then I thought to start record immediately. But I could not find all these options which generally will be visible on our screen. I'm using a mobile, sir. At the end of the meeting, I found those options. Even in between also, I tried to show them, but I could not find all those, sir.
They should be, the options should be available, ma'am. Before you start the meeting or if anybody joins, just look for those options. If you don't have, like, end the meeting and join back, okay?
Join again, sir?
Yeah, join again if you don't see it.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, if you still have that issue, let me know. Or let Pudina ma'am know so that we can take a look at. Okay.
And one more, sir. Mm-hmm. Like Zoom, we don't. Do we have any option to allow the children after we start the class? They are joining before us and they are starting chatting. They are talking with each other.
Yes, ma'am. We are looking into it. Microsoft enables something. So we did not test that yet. We do not want to make any changes right now, at least for this week. Maybe probably over the weekend, like Saturday after our school ends, school classes end, then me and Mrudula ma'am will be working on that and make sure if that is something that we can fix, we'll be able to fix that.
Okay, sir. And one more, sir, if you don't mind.
Yeah, go ahead.
When we are trying to share our photos, only first 1 to 5 photos only we are able to see on the screen, sir. So from those photos only we have to share. If our photo, for example, that picture which I have, that screenshots which I have already downloaded to show up for other classes, those were not visible, sir. Only 1 to 5 pictures which are in the past list, only those are visible, sir.
I did not get it. What are you sharing? Where are you downloading them from, ma'am?
Those pictures I'm taking screenshots and I'm storing in my mobile, sir. So okay. I'm storing all those, I'm saving all those in my photos. When I'm trying to share with the children, only first 5 photos will be visible. The remaining photos we cannot select, sir.
Yes, sir. This is very important question, sir.
In gallery, in Zoom, we can full gallery visible. We can select the photo, whatever we want, we can select and we can show. But here only first 5 photos are visible, sir.
Only first 5 photos are visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. I will check that also today. I wanted everybody to understand. So this is like your teacher's view where you will see all your classes. Okay. And on the other side, I have a student. This is a student view where they can see only their classes. So I just added the same student to couple of test. But they will see only one class for them. And they will see all the channels. So one thing here to notice, if any student says that they're not able to see something, so like apart from general, they should see their class subjects. Okay. If anybody says that they're not able to see like Hindi or math or something like that, like in this case. Like in this case, if they say they're not able to see it, ask them to click on to hidden channels. And if they click on hidden channels, they'll have an option to show. Okay. Once they select show, those will come up in the list so that student doesn't find where the class is, where the subject is. Okay, this is something that I got to know while talking to a parent. So if anybody complains that they're not able to see a class or they're not able to see a meeting, ask them if they see the subjects or not. If they do not see the subjects, ask them to go to hidden channels and view them. Okay. So let's look at the meeting. Meeting setup. So whenever we set up a meeting, okay. Do a couple of things here. So the first thing that we have to do is select the right channel. So what I observed is some of the teachers, they just select the general channel. If you do not have the subject listed, talk to Mudula ma'am, she will create one. Okay, always create the meetings for your respective subjects, do not create in the general. So let's say I want to do a test demo. And then do not check any of these. Select the time, whatever time you want to set the meeting for. Okay. Let's say I set it for 10 a.m. And then add to the channel. So let's say I do it for, so let's say your class is test class 2. Here, do not select general, select your subject. Okay. Always select your subject because we are asking students to go to their subjects. And look, and based on their schedule, based on the timetable we shared with the students, they will go to that subject and join the meeting from there.
Okay? Sir, the screen is not shared, sir. We can see the notepad here. The notepad is opened.
Notepad is opened.
Yeah. Yes.
Are you seeing the screen?
Yes, now we can see.
Are you seeing the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait, let me... Are you able to see it now?
Yes, yes.
This screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, for creating a meeting, I'll start from the beginning. Just go to calendar. Create meeting. Probably all of you have tried it. Okay. Give the subject. Just say whatever subject name is, or you know what topic you're explaining today. And then select the channel. So while selecting the channel, make sure you select the right subject. Don't just select general. Instead, select the class and select the right subject like this. Okay. You see some of the earlier. We've seen some of the meetings created in the general section or class. So let's not do that. Let's select this right subject. Okay. And then all we have to do is send. Okay, let's go from the, instead of going from the calendar, let's go from the Teams itself. So this is the student view. Student view, as you can see, if I go to the English subject, they are able to see the demo 2 class meeting that I have set up scheduled. So if I go to test class 2, so as you can see, there's a hidden channel. I open up this, and this is the meeting that we have scheduled. So this meeting is not ready yet, okay? So once the meeting is created, okay? Ideally, you should be able to go to the calendar and reopen the meeting. For some reason, the calendar is not loading up for me. But you can also go to Teams, go to that particular channel and open up the meeting. And here you have meeting options, okay? This option is available for desktop only, meeting right here. All other, like if you're using a mobile phone, you have meeting options here. Okay. So if you click either of these, it's going to open up in a browser. So make sure if you have Google Chrome used. If you open up in Safari or Internet Explorer or anything else, it will not open. Always use Google Chrome browser. Okay. So once the meeting is set up, go to meeting options, and here who can bypass lobby? Just people in my organization. What this does is nobody else would be able to join the meeting except for the students or anybody from Zena School will be able to join. If you select to everyone, outside people can join the meeting. So always make sure people in my organization selected. Always let callers bypass the lobby, select this. Announce when callers join or leave, select this because we do not want any disturbance if students join and leave the class or the session or the meeting. And then who can present, select only me. Because you will be the only person who will be selecting the meeting, you will be presenting the screen. So select only me. So these are the important options that you have to set. If you don't set these options, what will happen is, let's say you don't set who can present option. Let's say it's set to everyone. Then even students can start the recording. Okay. Let me just show it to you how it is. Let me just set it to everyone for now. Mrudula ma'am, can you join the meeting?
Yes, sir.
So I have joined the meeting as a teacher. Now I have a student joining the meeting. This is Vihan. I just added this. And let's wait for Mudula ma'am also to join. So now Susan also joined the meeting. But Mudula ma'am, you're not yet joined. I will also log in from my mobile phone. Just so that you get an idea of how to handle from mobile also. Ma'am, you join? Now if you see, this is the teacher view where I can see Mrudula ma'am and I can see all the participants. I am the organizer. Okay, this is the student view. Okay, here you can see how the student joins. As you can see, like a small difference here is for students we've disabled chat, where here, as you can see, teacher has a chat option, but student does not have the chat option. So they cannot chat between themselves, but they still can chat in the meeting. Okay. This is something that is something that we are looking at to fix it. Okay. So now I just send a hi message here. I can see a hi message from the student here. So this is something we are working on to disable the chat option in meetings also. I have one question here. So let's say if a student is not able to hear or anything, they will not be able to let you know. So we are still trying to figure out how we can. There is a raise hand option for the student. There is a raise hand option, but if I do a raise hand as a student, then the teacher has to go in and check. Or they have to see it on their screen of who raised hands and probably unmute them and ask the question. So we are still trying to figure out how to do it in a better way. Probably we'll have a option where they will be mute all the participants not to chat in the meetings also. Okay. So as you can see now here, so in the meeting options, I've set who can present to everyone, right? So now if I open up students, this is students account. Okay. Here, if I go to options, I can share my screen here. Okay. This is something that we don't want them to do, right? We don't want them to share their screen while teacher is present, right? So for this to be disabled, we have to set this meeting option to only me. So if I do this, let me sign off. If I do that, see immediately how the sharing option is disabled. Now if I send it to everyone and go back to the student, you can see that the option is enabled. Okay, so always make sure you set this to only me so that students will not share the screen. So students stay sharing the screen or sharing videos or anything, if you see that, then probably this is what we did not set up correctly. So always check for meeting options. Any meeting that you create, even if it's a recurring meeting, go set these four options. Who can bypass the lobby to only people in my organization. Always let callers bypass the lobby to no. Announce when callers join or leave to no. And who can present to only yourself, only me. Okay. If you set these options, students will not be able to make any changes or share anything. And we've by default disabled the video option for the students. This is because we got some complaints from parents regarding video sharing. And also there was a lot of disturbance when students are sharing videos because you know, the streaming quality, the audio quality went down. So that is why we turned off videos. Only you can share your video. Okay?
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, in spite of setting all that, today I can see one of the child has shared his video. Then how could it be?
When was it? Today morning, ma'am? Who is the child?
Yeah, he is Nihal Gaud.
Nihal Gaud, okay.
Nihal Gaud of 6th B.
Okay, ma'am, I'll make a note of it. I'll check what are the permissions for that student. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So one other thing is there is still, so I don't know if you have observed. So let me change this to everyone again. Okay. And if I change it to everyone here, okay, I said the meeting who can present to everyone, the student has the mute all option. Okay. If I set this to none, if I set it to only me, the student does not have the mute all option. Did you see that? So if you set one option here to only me, they will not be able to present. They will not be able to present and they will not be able to use the mute option. So I saw some complaints from teachers saying that students are muting while they are speaking. So this is the setting that you have to do. Always select this to no, and these issues will be resolved. So if you are facing these issues, then next time it will be on you. You have to make sure that these settings are set up correctly. We will not be able to validate the settings because these are your meetings. So because I've set up a meeting here, Mudala ma'am will not be able to see what meeting options I've set. Okay. These are your meetings. So make sure you have control on those meetings and you update the meeting policies, meeting options. So going back to meeting options again. So for mobile users, so let's say I go back to this. So for mobile users, this option is not available here. You have to copy the link here. When you are in mobile, you just tap that link. You'll have a copy option, copy that URL, paste it in a browser, and then you will be able to make changes. So probably it might ask you to log in again to make changes. So enter your credentials and update the meeting options.
Okay, sir, we have in mobile directly we can open meeting options.
Okay,
we have. Yes.
Okay, then Muslim, I'm saying I did not check it. So yeah, if it's there in the mobile version, then use that option and update the settings. Okay, this is very important because this one option will disable, will resolve a couple of issues for you. Okay. The other thing is when you are sharing your screen, okay, when you are on the desktop, when you click on the share, you will have only desktop sharing of a desktop screen. Okay. Or share a whiteboard option. Okay. The only way you can share, like if you're using a blackboard or a whiteboard to explain, the only way is to turn on the video. So like this, you have to use for while using a desktop, okay? But in mobile, okay? If you turn this video on in mobile, so let me, Mridula ma'am, do you have, maybe we disable the video sharing. So in mobiles, if you turn this video on, it will show your video in it will show basically four participants every time. Okay. Since this is desktop, it is not showing like that, but in mobile it will show. So let me see if I can share the screen. So you can see the screen right here at the bottom. So I logged in from my mobile. Here, if you turn on the video, okay, it's gonna show the video in one section, okay? This is something that is causing an issue and parents are raising concerns that students are not able to see the screen, okay? So do not use this video option in mobile, okay? In mobile, if you click on this options, you'll have a share option here. And then there is an option called share video. If I do this, then my whole video will be shown. Look how it's showing the whole video versus earlier when you shared, when you just turned on the video, it was showing only one, your video in only one screen. So let me turn this off. So again, I'm just showing the other option. If you just turn on the video, it's gonna show in one section. So this is a bigger complaint from parents saying that they're not able to see the screen. So today, I think we had class 1D or 1B teacher who was doing this, and we helped her to share the screen, and parents were able to see the entire screen and they were happy. Okay. Make sure you always use the share option. Okay. Always use a share option from the options, and then use the share video option. This is how you need to share your screen if you're using mobile phone, okay? If you're using desktop, all you have to do is share your screen. Just turn off video and you will be able to see the screen, okay? Any questions in this one?
Yes, sir. Actually, now when you turn on your video, we can see you only in one side of the screen, that is small. Can that be seen on the whole screen, sir?
So you can see it. So this is, we are showing it in a Zoom meeting, right, ma'am? So generally,
yes, ma'am.
When you share the screen, it's going to show up here. But in Teams, just like how I showed you earlier in the screen, in my phone, okay, it will show the screen. We are using a Zoom so that it's not showing up here, but in general it's going to show up in full screen mode. So let me
actually, today I have seen two more teachers, like classes, sir, where one teacher her screen, like my child can see her completely on the screen, where she's okay. Also using a desktop version, I mean she's also using a laptop, but the other child, she's also using laptop, but the screen.
So are you able to see it, ma'am? Are you able to see it now in a big screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is how big screen works. Okay. Let me stop present. Share the video. Okay. If I just share the video, see how it is showing up in the.
Is it in desktop version, sir?
Sorry, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Is it in desktop version? Actually, I have searched for the share video in my, like I'm using laptop, in that I have searched in the app, sir, but I couldn't find it. So is there any difference between?
Did you download Teams app, ma'am?
Yes, sir. I am using app. Is there any difference between app as well as what we use in web, sir?
No, ma'am, there is no difference. Here also, in app also, I will be able to share my screen. So this is, let's say this is my office one, but here also you will have this option to share screens and also share video. Okay.
Okay.
This is the version where you can share your screens. multiple, that's why it's showing multiple screens here. But then you also have, ideally you should also have the whiteboard option. I don't see it, but I've seen it in, I'm seeing it on the desktop, I'm seeing it here, but I'm not seeing it on my app. Probably just we need to install that whiteboard. Or you can just turn on the video. If you're using desktop, it is very simple. Just turn on the video or go share and share your screen. These are, it's very easy if you're using desktop. If you're using mobile, don't use this option. Okay. Use, go to share option. That is where you'll see a share video option in mobile phone. Use that option. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So that is one thing I wanted to cover here. Any questions so far on meeting setup, meeting options, and screen share? Any other questions before we move on?
Sir, excuse me, sir. Sir, do we have like in Zoom? We used to have when we used to share the whiteboard. We have the option of typing the text.
Okay.
And don't we have that option in this Teams, sir?
Typing the text, huh?
Yeah.
I am not sure, ma'am. I'll have to check. Probably we do not have it.
Because that was very easy for us whenever explaining the problem, and at the same time, simultaneously, we used to type each statement in front of them. And in that way, we used to do. Instead of writing on the board, we used to type the text. But okay. I think here we don't have that option. Because that handwriting used to be very clear for the children when we used to type.
Okay. I think we don't have it, ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sir?
And I'm not seeing that option. Let me open it in the app and see if there is a direct whiteboard. So this is just whiteboard using in Teams. So if we open the app, let's see if there is a different setup that Yeah, I do not see that option, ma'am. I'll make a note of it and I can let you know, okay?
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, now suppose in whiteboard we don't have text option. So we can share notepad and the other word. We can type, no, sir? From there, we can type and we can show to the students PowerPoint or Word or notepad.
We can open desktop, right, ma'am? We can open, share the screen, just like how I'm sharing the screen. And then you can open notepad and type here also.
So here they can change the font size. They can increase the font size and they can type and show to the students.
Yeah.
So we can share Word and PowerPoint also from here. Where the
you can share. So you can share. You can increase the. If it's a Word document, you just have to open the Word document and show it. So if you're using desktop, all of these are possible. If you're using mobile phone, you are restricted to. Okay? You can also when you're sharing your screen. Now I'm sharing my screen, right? I can simply.
We can text here.
Yeah.
Increase the font and the text. Yeah.
Simply do this. And then we just increase the font here. Yeah. They'll be able to see.
Very clear for the students.
If teachers are using laptops or desktops, it would be easy to do it this way.
Okay.
Any questions? Any other questions? Okay, let me stop presenting here. And then any other questions you have before we move on?
Agar time enta?
Hello. Okay, so let me mute all the participants. Right? One second. So the other options are, so Microsoft helped us in setting up Teams in a different way. So if I open up the other team, so earlier in this team, let's say the student has the option to exit. So if the student click on this, they have option to leave the team. Okay, there is another team structure that we have created here. If a student goes into the team, they will not have option to leave the team. So this weekend we will test this feature. And the other thing is, see how they have this muted option. So they will not be able to make any conversations. In the other team, if you see, they are able to make conversations, okay? But if you go to the team that Microsoft suggested, they will not be able to make like a chat in the Teams also. They do not have the chat option here, and they cannot chat in the meetings also, okay? In the Teams also. So we will check this option. The only issue that we have right now is we have to recreate all the meetings that we have already created. So we will take a look at it and see how we can fix that. If we could not fix that, then probably we'll ask all of you to create meetings again so that it will be easier for the admin team to manage, because we have some complaints from parents, and Mudula ma'am was saying that students are accidentally leaving the team and they are not able to join back. So in order to avoid those scenarios, we wanted to try this over the weekend and see how we can implement it. Any other questions?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, while class is going on, one child is making the other child to leave the class, sir. So how can I control that?
So even in this meeting, if you see, remove from the meeting option is there. This is again boils down to the fact that it's about the meeting option. So if I select, so if I go back to the meeting options here and set it to everyone. So here, if you see, remove participant is there, right? So now as a student, I can remove Susan from this meeting. So in order to avoid this, go back here and set the meeting option. This one little change is fixing a lot of issues for us. So let's say I've set it to only me. Now I go back as a student. I do not see that option at all. Did you see that? There's no remove participant. So if you set this meeting option to only me, three things are resolved. They will not be able to share the screen. They will not be able to mute all, and they will not be able to remove participants. Okay. Okay. So this is very important. So I have made some notes. So mute all, again, who can present if we set this option? Mute all is not available for students. Chat, we, as I said, we'll be working on the Teams over the weekend and see if that's possible, just like how we have seen here for the student. Where they are not able, if they go to a different team, they're not able to chat anything. Okay, so we'll try that option. Meeting options, I cannot stress enough on this. If you don't set these options, you will have all the problems, and we will not be helping you from now on. Mudula ma'am will not be helping you, or I will not be helping you. I will just join the meeting and see how it's going, but I will not be helping you again because this is something that we've been telling you from the beginning. This is very important option that we need to do. Okay. Meeting setup. Again, every time you set up a meeting, come back to the meeting and update the meeting options. Screen share. If you're using a desktop, you can just share, you can just use a video icon or share your whiteboard. If you're using mobile phone, use the share option and then share your video. Okay. And one other thing when we're talking about screen share is when teachers are sharing the video, they're not setting up at the right angle. Okay. Let me turn on my video here and show it to you how it is. So I don't know if you're able to see, but I'll do it here on my video. So instead of showing it like this, teachers are showing it like this or like this, something like that. So make sure when you adjust your phone or something, make sure when you're writing on the board here, make sure it's visible to the students. Before the meeting starts, check all of these options. Don't just start the meeting and adjust these during the meeting. We have 10 minutes of time between each class, right? Try to do all of these before the class so that we will not have any disturbance in the class. Okay, so try these things. This is something that I got to know while I was checking another class. So I just wanted to bring that. I don't want to point any teachers because I know it's new for everyone. But again, we have to learn. We have to keep learning new things. And because of the COVID situation, we are going online and we have to learn these things. We will be using these at least for another 2 or 3 months, right? Based on how the cases are going up. So make sure that you get accustomed to this and try all the features. Don't hesitate from trying new features. That's totally fine. Try new features. If you fail, that is fine. If you find something new, let every teacher know or let us know so that we can also implement that across the school and have those features implemented. Next thing is background noise. If you have background noise, all you have to do is click on the participants here. If you are using a desktop, you'll have the participants shown here. If you're using a mobile phone, just tap on the screen and you will see a participant list right here, okay, at the top. So go to the participants and then mute all. All you have to do is this. If I'm here, I'm seeing a lot of parents probably are typing in the team saying that there's a lot of background noise. Every time you hear somebody speaking when you're teaching a class, just go to options and mute all. This is something that you have to do. There is no way that I can restrict a student from unmuting. I can unmute myself here, right? I can talk. But if you are hearing background noise, just go to mute all. Just go to participants and use the mute all option. This is something that we have to do. And the other one is raise hand. If somebody raises hand, you will see a notification. Let's say I use a raise hand from a student. You will see a notification right here. Or you can see a number against the participant. This is the same thing in both desktop and mobile. You will see a number. So if you see this raise hand, that means somebody has a question, right? In the class, when student raises his hand, we will stop explaining what it is and then ask the student what is the question, right? It's the same thing. Okay, if you see anything here, just open up the participants, look at who has raised option, and then say, you can call out the name and then ask them what is the questions. And then you can also lower the hand because now you answer the question of the student, you can lower the hand and then ask the student to ask their question and respond to that. So it's similar to a class experience, but it is more like monitoring these options, okay? If somebody raises his hand, definitely it's going to show up in here, in the chat. Okay? This is something that probably we, I mean, it's new to you, but you should be monitoring this as, because you don't have students to monitor. You should be looking, sometimes you should be looking at the screen and say, hey, okay, I have a student who raised a hand. So let me go ask the question. Okay. These are some things that we have to do. Next is monitoring the participants. So again, I just said monitoring the participants just because of these options. So somebody might have a question or somebody might post a message or something like that. Okay. So if I, let's say, if I post a message, I will be able to see in the chat. See how you see a icon here. So these two you should be monitoring. For mobile phones, these two will be in the top right, chat and then participants. So even for mobile phones, you will see the chat option, the icons here, okay? Please start monitoring those also while you're explaining the class. Like, you know, probably once in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, something like that, if you start monitoring, then, you know, parents will be listening into the classes, right? They will be looking into the classes. They will get a sense of saying, hey, okay, teacher is responding whenever there are questions or not. Okay. So it's new to everyone. Okay. So let's try to make it easy for the students and parents so that we will not have any additional questions or any concerns raised. Okay. This is something that we need to get used to monitor both chat and participants. And whiteboard, I will, as you see, there's sharing, in sharing option, there's a whiteboard, but as ma'am pointed out, I will check, you know, if we can use a keyboard to enter in. If there is no keyboard, then as we already saw earlier, use the Word or notepad or something like that and type in for now, okay? And then we can look at these options later on. Okay, these are some of the things that I wanted to point out. Any other questions that you have? Anything that you want me to answer today?
Excuse me, sir. When classes are going on at that time, if they ask some questions through the chat, we have to answer them.
Yes, ma'am. It's like student asking a question in the class, right? Student will stand up or raise their hand and ask, ma'am, I have a question or something like that.
If they are raising their hands, we can answer, sir. If they are through chatting, if they are asking something, then also we have to answer.
We will disable chat for them, ma'am. Okay. We will disable chat for them. Okay. Probably tomorrow and tomorrow, Friday and Saturday, they will be able to still chat. But from Monday onwards, they will not be able to chat. Okay.
How they are chatting means, for example, ma'am, please mute all, and ma'am, this boy is talking, I can't able to hear you. Like that, they are sending a message.
Why do we have to wait for students to tell that this boy is talking or something like that? When the boy is talking, you will also be able to hear, right?
Yes, I immediately mute everyone.
Yeah, if you hear, then go and mute everyone, and that is it.
Yeah, I'm doing the same thing, but later or before they are chatting, they're sending this message.
Yeah, ma'am. From now onwards, we will disable the chat. All they have is raise hand option. Raise hand option available in both desktop and mobile phone. So all students will be able to raise their hands. Okay. If somebody raises their hand, make sure you answer the question immediately versus waiting for the end of the period. Okay. It might be a parent who raised a hand, right? They might be waiting for a teacher to respond or something like that. Okay. We have parents every home. They will also be monitoring the classes. They will be assisting the students in classes. So please ensure that if you always monitor the participants, and if they have any questions, answer those questions. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
And one other thing is recordings. I want every teacher to be recording the class before this class begins. If I don't see any recordings from the class, I probably have to ask the teacher to redo the class on her own time, on his or her own time, because we don't have all the students joining the classes. We still have students in rural areas or other places where they do not have internet access right now. But if we have these recordings, we can share them later on with the student and say, hey, this is what is happening in the class. This is what Aparna ma'am teacher thought on Wednesday. This is what Aparna ma'am thought on Thursday. So we can share those recordings and say, go through these classes. If you don't have the recordings, then when the school reopens, when students come into the school, there will be parents coming in and saying, we missed all these classes. We want the student to be taught all these classes, right? Then the management will not have an option but to come to you and ask you to take the classes as extra classes, right? So why do you want to redo the same work? Start recording every time that you start a meeting. I will be checking all the meetings right now. From tomorrow onwards, I will check all the meetings, and every meeting should have a recording. If I don't see a recording, probably I will be asking the teacher to redo the class, re-record the class. On our own time, just do a YouTube video or something like that. Just record it in the phone and post it. Because otherwise, without these recordings, whoever students misses the class, they will not be able to follow the next classes, right? Let's say a student did not come in for the first week and now he started in the second week. How will we be able to teach that student? There will be students who don't come for the first 2 weeks and then come from the third week. How will we manage all those? Okay, it's better to have these recordings so that we can share, saying, hey, these are the first week classes, go through these classes so that students can go, parents can help students go over those meetings in the evenings or in the afternoons. Okay, please ensure that you always start recording the classes. Even if you're just waiting for all the students to join, first thing you have to do is start recording. Any other questions? Murudila ma'am, any other questions?
Sir, once the class is ended, after 1 week or then, teachers was asking, can we cancel the classes, the done classes? If they cancel, so will this recording also will be vanished, it will be deleted?
No, recording will be there. Recording will always be there. Okay. Recording will always be stored. So let me show some of the recordings here. They will always be shared. So probably I'll just go to 7B. Recordings will always be saved forever in Microsoft video platform. They will not be deleted. This is something that we got confirmation from Microsoft also. See, this meeting got recorded, but looks like let me just show a test class. See, here is a recording from probably Harisha, I guess, recorded by Harisha ma'am. They can go back to these videos and open up. So if they click on this video, it will open up and then they will be able to see. This was recorded on last Friday and the video is still there. This video will be available for all classes, okay? And this is something that we don't want to happen. We don't want to share only part of the screen, okay? See how it's recording is there. Students will now be able to follow the class. Whoever have missed the classes, they will be able to see and then see this video and then follow what's taught in the class. Okay. And see how initially Harisha ma'am did not share her full screen, just shared the video. That is why she is able to, that's why it's part of the videos, like how it's one part of the screen. If she had shared the whole video, like using the share option from the mobile, teacher would have been able to be on the full screen. Okay. So these are some things that we need to keep in mind while recording and while also sharing the screens. Any other questions? Jaya ma'am, any suggestions from you?
Thank you. I don't have anything right now. Everything is cleared. Even today evening, we had the meeting for the lower class teachers. So we had different options for doing the videos and PPTs and so on. So we'll work out, not in a hurry like, but we will definitely have a good output by all these meetings. I think by now teachers are aware of how to use Microsoft Teams and how to go about. So nothing as of now. Thank you.
Okay. One more thing I wanted to point out is when you end the meeting, on the desktop, you have an end meeting, which will end the meeting for everyone. If you're using a mobile phone, you will not have this end meeting option. Okay. I request all the teachers to know the timetable of their class and let the students know which class to join so that they can ensure that all the students drop off. So how does it ensure all the students drop off? You can look at the participant list and look at all the attendees. So let's say I drop off this call. If a student drops this call, you can see that the student is no more as part of the meeting. Okay. So you need to ensure that all students drop off if you're using a mobile phone, and then only end your call. Okay. Before that, we don't want teachers to drop off because we are seeing that students are remaining in the previous classes when the next class already started and they're waiting for the teacher to come. So this has happened at least the last 3 times, and I had to tell the students end the meeting here and then go join whichever subject. Okay. So teachers should know the timetable of each class that they are part of so that they can let the students know what is the next class they have to join. So there could be students missing the calendar or anything. It's better that we also make a point that we tell them which class to join and ensure that all students drop off the meeting and then only end the meeting here. Is that clear or any questions?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, ma'am.
Sir, regarding chat option, so when we are in the meeting, whatever the chat going on in the general, we couldn't see that, sir. When we end the meeting, then only we could see that chat that some students couldn't join the meeting. So they are chatting in the general place where we couldn't see or invite the students.
That is why, ma'am, they are chatting in the general channel because they don't know which class to join. Okay. So if you tell them which class to join, if we might have already shared the timetable with all the students, right?
Yes, sir.
So if let's say if they join your class and they don't join the next class, we need to tell them which class to join. Okay, there are kids like fifth class, sixth class, they get confused, right? Using the system, yes, for the like how we are using it for the first time, they are also using it for the first time. Okay. So let us help them join the classes so that at least, you know, in the first 2 weeks, if we help them, they will be able to figure out which class to join next and all. You know, one or 2 weeks of routine will help them to follow that routine going forward. Okay. Let's help them in 2 weeks and they will be able to, like, we will not have any issues, you know, after that.
Okay. So one more thing I want to raise is when the wrong meeting is created, so we are canceling that meeting, sir. But if we see in the child, like students and this one, Microsoft like Teams, they are getting confused in the calendar with the canceled meetings and the meetings which they have to attend. Is there any option for us
to remove it completely so that it will not be displayed in students' calendar?
It will not be displayed in students' calendar.
Yeah.
So.
So you can see the cancelled meetings here, sir. So in the same day, even in the students' calendar, it is showing, sir. So they are getting confused with these things also. So is there any way to remove those things completely? And any delete option for this?
Let me see, ma'am, here.
Excuse me, sir. When we are creating, when we are making a meeting, I mean, if, for example, on Monday, we have first period, 9 to 9:40. We are scheduling. That is 10th today. Okay. Again, we have next Monday class. After that meeting, we can just change the date. What is the next Monday date we have to see? And that date we have to change. No need to schedule all those things and no need to go to that meeting option, right? If we schedule, change the date, it will reschedule to next Monday. It will not come like it is cancelled.
If it is a recurring meeting, why can't we create just a recurring meeting?
In mobile, we will not get that option, right? Alternative days if we have. In mobile, we can't do like that, sir.
In mobile, we can't do a recurring meeting? What are you saying?
Every day,
we can.
Alternative days, we can't. Through, if it is laptop or through desktop, we can. But through lap, through phone, we can, we can't, sir. Just we should change the date. With the changing the date, we can schedule next meeting. I mean, next Monday meeting.
If you're using mobile and you don't have that option, then just create two meetings, ma'am. So for all Monday classes, create one meeting. For all Wednesday classes, you create one meeting. That would be easier, right? Why do you want to go every week and use the date and everything? Just create two meetings and as recurring meetings and say and that should do it, right? Why do you want to, like, once if you create those two meetings initially and set them as recurring for Monday and Wednesday, then that will be taken care of for the rest of your classes, right? You don't want to be creating it will be hard on you only to manage all those meetings. You have like 6 classes or 8 classes to teach in a week, and if you're doing that for all the 8 classes, imagine how much time you're spending on that. If you just create those 8 meetings separately as recurring meetings for that particular day, it will solve the problem for you, right?
We have weekly options, sir. If they have Monday, Wednesday and Friday, we can go for weekly option. Every Monday we can give the recurring meeting. Then every Wednesday we can give the recurring meeting. For every Friday, we can give. In that way, we can give.
Yes, that is what I'm saying. For every Monday meeting, you just create one meeting. For every Wednesday meeting, you create a new meeting and set the meeting options. For every Friday meeting, create another meeting as a repeating meeting for that Friday. And then, so if you do that, you don't have to like recreate or manage the meetings every week. Try to reduce the burden. If you have any questions, reach out to Mudula ma'am. And get help from her. Okay, try to reduce as much burden on your end. Try to focus on all these setups and everything. We've already gone through these setups and everything, and probably most of you are aware, except for some of the options. So try to reduce that burden. Try to not create more and more meetings. Just create a recurring meeting, and it should handle for you.
Okay, thank you.